والسابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم.
The Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, نعم, Allah said, Allah is pleased with them and them pleased with him. All of them عدول, all of them trustworthy, all of them Allah is pleased with. That's different. Not just the 10 promised paradise. All of them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. Without exception. Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, رضي الله عنه. Amr ibn As, رضي الله عنه. All of them. Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, رضي الله عنهما. Him and his father. May Allah be pleased. Nowadays you find the Hizb al-Tahreer, they say he's not even Sahabi. Naam. We found that in one of the, we're talking about now 15, 20 years ago, in their leaflets. You see, many of the young brothers have come into the da'wah now. They don't know what we went through. And what the brothers in the Maktaba Salafiyah in this country 20 years ago, 25 years ago, what they went through in fighting the misguidance of these people who are leading many, many people astray. Many people astray. There was wars, Ikhwan. There were battles with these individuals who brought out their false ideologies. They used to say Muawiyah radiallahu anhu that he's not a Sahabi. Why? Because they have their own definition of Sahabi. Their definition is, as Umar Bakri and they used to say, what is their definition? That the Sahabi is he who lived with the Messenger for 2 years. What rubbish is this? Are you going to bring a deen? Am lahum kitabun fihi? Am lakum kitabun fihi tadrusun? As Allah says in Surah Al-Qalam. Do you have a book which you study from? That you say a Sahabi is the one who lived with Rasulullah for 2 years. Who said? Did Allah say that? Did the Nabi say that? Did the Sahaba say that? What did the Messenger say? Tawba liman ra'ani wa amana bi. Glad tidings for the ones who saw me. But in this case, it means met me because some of the Sahaba were blind. Naam. Tawba is a tree in paradise. Glad tidings. Bushra for them. The ones who saw me or met me. In this case, it means met me. Wa amana bi and believed in me. This is where we get definition of Sahabis. From where? From the hadith of Rasulullah. And Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah, explained it. And he said, the ones who met, what is meant here is the ones who met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even if it's an hour, he met with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he believed in him and he died upon that. And he died upon Iman. He died upon Iman. So for example, the king of Habasha, of Ethiopia, was he a Muslim or not? He was a Muslim, became a Muslim, sah? Who gave him da'wah? Huh? Ja'far and also Amr ibn As afterwards. Now check it out. Look. The king of Habasha, Ethiopia, did he see the Messenger Sassim or not? No. So is he a companion? Did he meet the Messenger Sassim or not? He was the one who gave da'wah to Amr ibn As. A tabi'i gave da'wah to a sahabi, eventually became sahabi. Naam, Shaykh Abdul Muhsin mentioned this in the Sunan al-Majadars. A tabi'i, because he didn't meet the Messenger Sassim nor see him, so he's a tabi'i. He is a successor. And he gave da'wah to Amr ibn As, who came there initially, not as a Muslim. He gave da'wah to him and became a Muslim. He went back to Medina, he met the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or he'd met him before. So Shaykh Abdul Muhsin said, this is from the fawaid of learning al-Rijal, or learning about the Sahaba, the names and who they were, and their life and their background. A tabi'i gave da'wah to a Sahaba. So you can ask question, which tabi'i gave da'wah to an individual who became a Sahabi afterwards? The king of Habasha giving da'wah to Amr ibn As, radiallahu anhum. So here, this is the definition of Sahabi. So what did they say? The Hizb al-Tahrir, they try to misguide you. It's not Sahabi. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu is not Sahabi, they say. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. Why do they concentrate on Muawiyah? What is the reason? Because they are political activists. They are not concerned with ibadullah, the ibadah to Allah. They are political activists. But there are many political activists. Is this the thing that you're going to get into paradise, being a political activist? What is the thing that's going to get you into Jannah first and foremost? Tawheed. Tawheed was Sunnah. Worshipping Allah alone upon ikhlas and following the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until you die. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, until he died. He says, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى عيسى بن مريم ولكن قولوا عبد الله ورسول. He is happy to be Abdullah. And you're not happy to be Abdullah. Allahu Akbar. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا. Shouldn't I be a grateful slave? And you're not happy to be a grateful slave. You want to be a political activist and criticize the Sahaba because of politics. Subhanallah. That's why Abu Tawbat al-Halabi, one of the Salaf, he mentioned, he said, Muawiyah radiallahu anhu is a sitter, is a curtain for the rest of the Sahaba. When that is uncovered, they speak against the rest of the Sahaba. This is why we must defend Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. And this is why we must defend the likes of Amr ibn As. Because in fact, we will be defending all of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. So those who don't have the book and didn't buy it, buy it. The book of Sheikh Abdul Musa Abbad, Aqwal al-Munsifin fi Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. The statements, the just statements, the balanced statements regarding Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan by Sheikh Abdul Musa Abbad, which was translated in 2001, 9 years ago. And it's available. أقوال المنصفين. If you can read Arabic, buy the Arabic. أقوال المنصفين في معاوية ابن أبي سفيان. نعم. And you can find it in English. It's translated. Statements after statements about defense of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم in refuting the Rawafid and the political activists who tried to speak against the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم. معاوية رضي الله عنه. He wrote hadith for Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعم. We want to criticize. And it was said by Ibn Abdulaziz, rahimahullah, how could I, or Abdullah Mubarak, he said, how could I speak about an individual who, when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Sami Allah liman hamida, he's saying, Rabbana wa laka alhamd. Subhanallah. He was praying with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you want to speak against him? And you want to speak against this great companion? And Sheikh Abdul Musa Abbad says in that book, whatever transpired is very minute compared to the great actions that they did. Very minute. Why? Because hadith. لو أن أحدكم تصدق بأحد ذهبا ما بلغ مد أحد ولا نصيفة. If one of you were to give charity the size of Uhud in gold, you would not be able to reach even a mud of one of them, or even half of that. Two hands put together is one mud. Half of that is one hand of whatever measure. Sheikh Rabi Habullah says, that's considering they only did one that. But what did they do? Did they only do one mud, ya ikhwan? Or half a mud? They had jihad. They had migration. Hijrah. Some of them two migrations. They had been tortured. They carried this deen. نظر الله امرئا سمع مقالتي فوعاها وأداها كما سمعها. Hadith Sahih Muslim. May Allah brighten the face of a person who heard my statement and he carried it. He proclaimed it as he heard it. Isn't this what they did? May Allah brighten their faces, ya akhwan. Illuminate their faces. The Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, the best people from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. And this is what Hizb al-Tahreer would say. Speaking against Muawiyah radhiyallahu anhu, that is not even a Sahabi. This is why, what Islamic state are you trying to establish? Which speaks against Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum. What kind of state? You want another Afghanistan killing each other? That's what's going to happen in your da'wah. In the end, because you didn't actually concern yourself with establishing the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. You didn't concern yourself with rectifying the people's belief in how they should love the Sahaba, in how they should believe in Allah and worship Him alone. You didn't busy yourself with this. You don't even busy yourself with teaching people how to pray. And you want Islamic State. What kind of state do you want? Wasting the people's time and energy.